Hey, welcome back to the Finbus channel. This is your friend Shamil Sajjad, and this is where you come for in-depth content on business and finance. We are in our weekly swing trading segment, and in today's segment, we will be looking at Kingfa Science and Technology. Before moving on to this segment, please subscribe this channel if you have not yet subscribed.
The major product categories in which the company operates are reinforced polypropylene compounds, thermoplastics, elastomers, fiber reinforced composites, and engineering plastics. The major application of these products come in the manufacturing of cars. The company has got 4 manufacturing facilities in Chakan Pune, Jejuri Pune, Pondicherry, and Manesar in Haryana. The company has more than doubled its sales figures in the past 5 years. The sales figures were 314 crores in 2016, 427 crores in 2017, 601 crores in 2018, 701 crores in 2019, and 741 crores in 2020. The company's profit margin has suffered for the past 5 years. In spite of the rising sales, the company hasn't been able to maintain its profit margin. The net profit of the company in 2016 was 11 crores, in 2017 12 crores, 2018 25 crores, in 2019 it dipped to 19 crores, and in 2020 it rose again to 2018 levels of 25 crores. Now we'll look at some important ratios of the company. The debt equity ratio of the company is 0.13, that the company is using only 13% debt in its capital. Earnings per share is at 20, which is a healthy one. Return on capital employed is at 10%. Capital employed includes reserves and surpluses, equity and debt. Market capitalization of the company is at 531 crores. PE ratio of the company is below the industry average of 25. And the PE ratio of the company is at 22 at present. Price to book value of the company is 1.52, from which we can conclude that the company is not at very overvalued levels at present. The share price of the company is at present trading above all the simple moving averages except the 200-day simple moving average, which shows considerable bullishness in the stock. The average directional index of the stock is at present at 16.23, which is indicating a weakening of a long-term negative trend in the stock. The positive directional index of the stock is at 33 and the negative directional index is at 13. Clearly, the positive demand in the stock is much higher than the negative supply. The relative strength index of the stock is at 65, which is close to 70 levels, indicating a short and medium term bullishness in the stock. The stock is currently trading at 445 to 450 levels. With the current kind of momentum, a first target of rupees 500 and a second target of rupees 550 seems possible. Just to add perspective, the stock has made an all-time high of 1,300 rupees in May 2018. In case the stock reverses, a stop loss of rupees 400 seems reasonable for swing traders.
I hope the video was useful to you. Please share and subscribe this channel. Please press the bell icon to receive timely notifications. Thank you for your time. Until we meet again, it's bye from me.